down to the floor. All your mic here set, let's go.
Hello and welcome to another edition of the Pepperbird Magazine's production of Africa Teaching. I'm J. Rodney Chesson, your host. Today we are in Charlottesville, Virginia, at the grave site of our third and great president, Thomas Jefferson. Now, as you know, Thomas Jefferson was an idealist. He was a great writer, and many of his ideas helped to spawn and build this great nation. He was a writer of the Declaration of Independence, and he also established the University of Virginia, which was one of his last acts before he died at 83. Now, behind me is his grave and the grave of his family at the Jefferson, Thomas Jefferson Parkway, which is also known as Monticello. And as you all know, Jefferson was also instrumental in helping a lot of people. Many of his slaves that worked with him after their emancipation, some of them even returned to Africa. Now, my story, as it relates to Thomas Jefferson, is that my maternal grand aunt, who was the late Nancy Fremont Wordsworth, the wife of the late Liberian Associate Justice William E. Wordsworth, who lived in Carisbrook, Liberia. I remember from childhood, while we were playing in the dirt, she would always say to us, "Get out of that dirt. Do you know you all came from Thomas Jefferson Plantation?" And this is why it was important for me to visit this plantation, to see who was this man that my people were so proud of, and who was this man who had this plantation that my people left here and went to Africa for. Now stay with us as we show you around Monticello and show you the house of Thomas Jefferson, his plantation, and many of the sites around here. And we hope you enjoy. Thank you.
I was all alone, was so bad. And there she go, she touched my heart and said, "Ebezina knows who go." Hey, was so glad. The way she keeps me smiling, it brings me joy. She proves this loving is real. Within my heart there's no. Take you away, mommy, me, yeah. See the girl I want marry, no time, no delay, yeah. After all the things I've been through, I present my love to you. The girl I want marry, yeah. The girl I want marry, yeah. See the girl I want carry, yeah. Now the girl I want marry. Oh, Rona, no, no, mume, no, mume. Oh, man, chanwa. What a beautiful onyinye, nenye makagi. So you and I can fly away, straight to the sky, just you and I. Girl, I know the lie. Can't you see? You were sent from above, and you know you're my heart and my sweetness. My sweetness. Is this love? Is this love? I don't know, but I know what I'm feeling. My God be my witness. You're my princess, hey, hey. The way she keeps me smiling, it brings me joy. She proves this loving is real. Within my heart there's nobody else. Make you give me your. take you away. Mommy, me, nebe, yeah. See the girl I want marry, no time, no delay, yeah. After all the things I've been through, I present my love to you. The girl I want marry, yeah. The girl I want marry, yeah. See the girl I want carry, yeah. Now the girl I want marry, mama let me see you.
Kiss me underneath the mistletoe. Okay, Nidi, I'm on the Anya Gadi. Makana, if you need it, Nemeregi. Yeah.
Yo.
Young B.
Alaney and Young B.
Ready.
Let's go.
Yeah. She only naira. She only pound sterling. She only dollar. She be ubi millionaire. Wapa mi jewo. Follow me, let's be happy. Follow me, chop my money.
Now, you know this man, Monroe, was not the father of our country. He was not the father of revolutionary zeal in Congress, Mr. Adams, our second president. He was not the father of our political liberty, Mr. Jefferson, our third president. And he certainly wasn't the father of our Constitution, Mr. Madison, our fourth president. He lived at Montpelier, just 30 miles to the north of us. He was, in fact, the fifth and sometimes forgotten president, the last of our founding fathers. John Quincy Adams, Monroe's Secretary of State and future sixth president of the United States, said of Monroe, no president did more to extend the limits of the United States and foster the security of the nation than James Monroe. Now that's pretty high praise coming from a man who rarely praised himself and didn't always have nice things to say about other people. So the question is it true? Well, when Monroe took office in March of 1817, we had one secure frontier after the War of 1812, and that was the Atlantic Ocean. When he left office 8 years later, he had secured much of our northern frontier, the border between Canada and the United States, east of the Rocky Mountains. He demilitarized the Great Lakes. He pushed the Russians out of northern California, back into Alaska, from whence they'd come. He strengthened our Navy. He strengthened our Army. He was the one who finished up West Point, pardon me. He realized we needed a place to train a cadre of professional officers that the Army and militia had not performed universally well during the War of 1812. And he gave us a series of coastal fortifications along the eastern seaboard that went all the way into the interior so far as the confluence of the Missouri and Mississippi rivers. So that doesn't sound like homeland security. I don't know what does. But Monroe literally changed the configuration of the United States. He was the lead negotiator for the purchase of Louisiana, which doubled the size of our country. He was the one who purchased Florida. He was the one who gave us the Transcontinental Treaty of 1819 with the Spanish, which gave us a whole new border just north.